So I'm Julien Legrand from Bull. I'm a technical leader on the Jasmine project, and I will present to you Jasmine Probe. So it's a part. It's a work. This work is a part of EasySOA project, which will be presented to you by Mark tomorrow morning, I think. Yeah. So feel free to go and see him. Okay, first OW to Jasmine. Jasmine can be seen as a toolbox for distributed system management. Initially, we started with we focused JVE clusters management. So in Bull, we focused on the Jonas server and then extended on all JVE servers and clusters. Then we enlarge the focus, go to service-oriented architecture, and now we are focusing cloud infrastructure, and so we add new features and new properties in our system. So Jasmine provides several features, so deployment, monitoring. You can find in the project some probes, some web console to visualize your graph or things like that. Notification mechanisms, and we also implement automatic or autonomic, as you want, behaviors for automatic reconfiguration of a system, or in a cloud it's fit very well with elasticity or things like that. We already implemented this kind of things in a founding project like Forecast. Okay, so here I will focus on a little part of Jasmine, which is Jasmine Probe. This is not the sexiest part of the project and probes. Not so cool, but we all have probes. We all need to supervise our systems. We all need to have statistics, performance. We all need to know if the systems is okay. And with the cloud, we also need to have an idea of the usage of our system for accounting or things like that. So I will make you a brief presentation for Jasmine Probe, and this is more a call for participation or contribution to enrich the Jasmine Probe. Sorry. Okay. So, main objective, really simply, and no. So what we want to provide is data collection. Here I list statistic performance, but we don't want to limit to this kind of indicators. We want to collect them periodically or not. It could be one shot. Optionally, we want to process to make process on data collected, like simple process. We don't want to re-implement complex event processing and things like that. We just want to add little intelligence in the probe to be able to determine some average, some min value, max value, or things like that. And finally, we want to publish results. So this is basically what we want Jasmine Probe to provide. But we want to go a little bit further. So we decide to base our architecture on OSGI. As you understand, at Bull, we are really OSGI focused. And all our products are made on top of OSGI. It's not a Ruby, I don't know how to say. What we want to provide is a system, a modular system, and dynamic systems. If you use a probe, you don't need for Java system, you don't need to embed the code of system data collection or things like that. So we want to be able to fit the probe at the right size. Another property OSGI provides to us is the possibility to extend, to easily extend our probe system. Here are just the key concepts of Jasmine Probe. So if we have a core with a manager, scheduler for periodical pulling or things like that. And the most important part are the collectors. For now, we provide generic GMX collectors. We also provide a system collector to get information on CPU, memory, or things like that. And the three points are for what you can provide and what we want to provide in the future is the extensions. The third concept is the authors, so where we will publish the result. For now, we have three kind of authors. One which publish information in the Jasmine monitoring servers. A second in a simple file as in the comma separated value format, and another in a standard console. The same authors can be extended. So if you need another author or publish information in your own system, it's quite easy to develop the new author. And the next concept are the operation for processing, as I said before. So for now, we have four big categories. So aggregation, correlation, derived indicator, and another stuff, a dummy category where we don't know. So for now we have several operations like max, min, percent, plus, minus, and you can easily make operation with the data collecting. As I said before, collectors, authors, and operation are extensible, and it's quite easy. You just have to define a new class extending the G collector, and to implement at least the get last result. And this class has to be packaged as an OSGI bundle, which can be deployed on a running Jasmine probe, and this automatically extend your probe. It's the same for an outer. Okay, look, so a class to which extends the GOuter package as OSGM bundle. User interaction. So Jasmine Probe provides you several ways to deal with it. We provide you a shell, so a command line. You can start, define, start, stop, and things like that to manage your probe. We have a web console which is in development, and you can define all your probes in an XML file. Here is just a screenshot of the web console, which, as I said, is still in under development. Okay, for the roadmap, for now we have the project is in its early stage, so we have milestone 7, which is already available. I didn't publish it on the Jasmine website, but it's available on the OW2 Maven repository. And we plan to release a stable version for the end of the year with shell improvement. So we want to implement completion and historic stuff in the shell. We want to finalize the web console. We want to provide Maven archetype to help you to develop a new collector and outer. And I'm not sure this will REST interface will be available in this version, but in the near future. So if you want to have information, stay tuned, and you can go to the Jasmine OW2 website or on the mailing list, jasmine@ow2.org.
Okay, thank you very much for your attention.